All right, welcome back. Today I'll be going through what I did yesterday, except with you guys able to hear me this time. That should go fairly quickly, and then we'll go into the challenging puzzles from there. And I've already made a mistake. Let's start over. What mistake did I make, you ask? Well, what fun would it be to play this game without a challenge? Alright. Let the challenge begin. Which picture is me? Let's take the green one again. Sure. Yeah. Yeah, Gesundheit to you too. Alright. Hostel. Okay. You have something, and you make a program. Basically, here are your commands. You want to make a program out of them, and fulfill the objective that's spelled out in the objective section. In this case, there's really only one program we're able to write, which is take items from the inbox and put them in the outbox. Oh, right. And don't just do this for the first item, but do this for every item. So, I know that sounds really complicated, but we'll see in later puzzles that this game does get challenging. Do this. Lettre postale. Okay. Basically, now we got an additional command, jump. Well, I think you know what we need to do. We need to take items from the inbox and put them into the outbox. Fascinating stuff, right? Now it's pointing out that I can just click over here and speed up the program. And so I do. Alright, tutorial number 3. Copier tag. Ooh. So we want to spell out the letters bug, and just to indicate that this input here is buggy. So copy the B, output it, copy from the U, and output the U, copy the G, output the G, and we're done. Right. The something was repaired. Something, 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 something. Nicked, I think, means not. And sortieren probably means sorted. And so, if I remember right, this wants me to sort them in the opposite of the order that they're currently in. So if I just take items from the inbox and dump them in the outbox, he's going to say, hey, 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 what you doing? He's going to say he wants the 7 instead of the 4. So, basically, we take an item from the inbox, copy it over here, take the next item. I'm sorry, we want to copy it to there. Take the next item, output it, and then take the item in memory and output that. So there's our 2. Then we took the 9 and put it directly out there, and then put the 2 behind it. And you get the idea. Coffee Break, Year 5. Alright, back to work.
Huh.
We'll see what happens with that. Something summer. Alright. Welcome into my room. No, yesterday somebody was telling me what Albtraum means. I was never good in math because I had only 3 fingers in each hand. I only know that because somebody said that. I was watching somebody stream yesterday. This is one of the few levels I did see them play. So, take numbers two wise, or take each pair of numbers, add them together, and output the result. So, copy that to slot 0. Take that, add it. And then take the result, print it out, and repeat. Hey, welcome back. Gotta say, I like the animation to this. I like the game design. It's beautiful. I just wish there were a way I could make this challenging without having to do it in a foreign language. But, you know, do it we must. Alright, let's side quest. Year 8. I assume this means, where were you? Something, something. And what is this? No, this is something, I don't know. But pretty much this person's not happy. Okay. Take the thing in the inbox and put it into the outbox. Yeah, I'm not sure what this is asking. I forget. Despite having seen and solved this yesterday. So, let's see what happens. 6. No, no, no. We wanted 18. Well, okay. 6 plus 6 plus 6 is 18. I might remember that from something I saw yesterday. So, if I remember that right, we're gonna copy that and then add it to itself and add it to itself again, print it out, and be done with it. And I did this with 6 instructions, which was the ideal number of instructions. And 24 steps, which is as fast as it can execute. Or at least for a 6-instruction program, that's the fastest it can go. Okay. Take each number. Mit 8. Multiply mit 8. All right. So let's take each number, copy it to address 0, add it to address 0, take that, copy it, and add it, take that, copy it, add it, print out the number, and then do the same for every number thereafter. Let's try that. Again, I'm kind of cheating because I did this yesterday with about as much ease, but we'll see. We'll get to, like, year 20 or something, and then this will get challenging. Okay, so this... Our last two puzzles were multiply by 3 and multiply by 8. This one is asking you multiply by 40. So, how do you achieve that? Well, if I remember right, I take a number, copy it to address 0, add it to itself, so we got twice, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times the number, and copy it to address 0, and then start multiplying it by itself. So, that's 10 times, 20 times, and 40 times, and then print it out, and then jump back to the beginning. If I remember right, it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 20, 40, 80, and print it out. That's how you multiply by 40. It's magic. Nice. So that's the side quest. Let's go back to the main quest. Alright, what was the deal with this one? The number is 0, do not put it in the outbox. Alright, so we're going to take each number, put it in the outbox, and then jump back to the beginning. And if we have a 0, we're just going to skip that. So there we go. So take the 3, print out the 3, take the 0, chuck it, and there you go. There we go. 4 steps. Or 4 instructions, 23 steps. Can't ask for anything better. Alright, send the zeros. Maybe this means send only the zeros into the outbox. Again, I think I'm just remembering that from yesterday. So yeah, here's how you do it. If you get a 0, put it in the outbox. You start the program by jumping to this step. So watch this. Ew! Hang on. I missed something. Right. So if we got a 0, we jump there, else we just jump here. Let's try that. Got a 6, chuck it. Got a 0, print it. We've got 8, chuck it. It's a B. There we go, put the 0. Another 0. And there's our last 0. Ideal, so let's move on. Subgon, subtraction. Alright, I think this probably is asking me to subtract the number from the other number and print it out. So let's try that. We'll subtract that, print it out, and then jump back to the beginning. So we got 1, we've got a 6 minus the 1, there's our 5, okay, we got an 8, 2 minus 8 is negative 6. Oh, I got it wrong. Oh, right, so this one... Yeah, this is the one it wanted me to print out the positive and the negative differences. So if I remember the way I did that yesterday, is I said copy the numbers to slots 0 and 1. Subtract 0, put it in the outbox. Copy from address 1. And subtract from address 0. That's wrong. Wrong, wrong, wrong. I'm going to copy from address 0 and subtract from address 1 and print that out and then jump to the beginning. So you got a 4 and a negative 4, a negative 6 and a 6, a 0 and a 0, a negative 7 and a 7. And there we go. Okay, so we're going to get to the challenging puzzles soon. This is telling me we have comments. Take numbers by pairs. If they are of equal sign, put the first in the outbox. I'm confused. Or maybe if they are equal, print the first in the outbox. Yeah, I don't get it. Let's just assume that only equal things are supposed to get printed. Let's just start with the naive assumption that that's right. So we're going to take the first number, put it in memory, take the second number, subtract the number in memory, and if we're 0, go up to the start. Start being where we say we're going to copy from that memory location and print it out. And if we're not 0, we're just going to repeat our loop without printing anything out. And we need to start the program by jumping, you get the idea. So we got a 4, which is not equal to 2. So we just chuck that. We got a 4, which is equal to 4. As we discover through the magic subtraction, so we print out the 4. 1 and 6 are not equal. So we just chuck that, and we got a 9, and 9 is equal to 9, so we print it out, and we're done. Okay, something. I have a feeling that this Gestell probably means something about feeling, but it is not profitable, I guess if we're just printing out identical numbers. We want the greater number. Take numbers by pairs, and print the greater number in the outbox. If they are equal, I don't know what that means. If they're equal something. Yeah, I don't get that. But let's take the number, copy it into slot 0, take the next number, copy it to slot 1, subtract from slot 0. If we're equal to 0, just say we're not going to print anything. If or negative. I don't know. We're going to do something special. Let's say we are going to take from address 0 and just output it. Else, if we're positive, we're going to copy from address 1. And print out that value. Let's try that. Whoops, and I forgot to say that when I start my program, I will need to jump to the part where it says take the first number. It's a fun little way of learning assembly there. So we see that 8 is the greater number, we print that out. Got negative 5 as compared to negative 6. And we discover that negative 5 is the greater number. Now we get equal numbers, 3 and 3. Not sure what it wants me to do. I'm just going to skip it and say we got a 6 and a 4. And we discover a 6 is the greater number. Oh, okay. Apparently, if the numbers are equal, we just take either one. So, you know, let's just take that jump out, repeat all this, and magic. Ooh, we have an extra step in here. Well, that's not ideal. Is there some way I can remove said extra step? Okay. Well, let's assume that we don't need memory address 1, and we can just restore the initial number by adding. So if we have numbers 3 and 1, we put the 3 there, take the 1, do the 1 minus the 3. If we've got a negative number, we add the 3 back to get their initial 1. I think that'll work. Oh yeah. Assembly for the win. Ha! Okay. So, yeah. I'm not sure what this means, but I think 31 is better than 34, so I certainly met the objective there. So what if machines have surrounded the city? I'm not afraid. Let's go to the exclusive lounge. Okay, this one I struggled a ton with yesterday. So I eventually figured out that this said take the numbers pairwise, or take them by 2, and print a 0 when they have the same sign. Either they're both positive or both negative. Otherwise, print a 1. I'm not sure what Vorzeichen means, but this probably means some kind of like comparison with 0. So if they're both greater than or both less than 0, print a 0, else print the 1. And this came down to trial and error. So start, we take a number. For negative, we're going to jump one place. Else, for positive, we take the next number. And if the second thing we get is negative, okay, if we get two positive numbers in a row, we're going to copy from zero. Or, yeah, copy the zero from address four. And we'll make instruction one print something in the out box. Alright. Else. We're gonna copy from 5 and then jump and print something. But this doesn't account for everything. So if our first number is negative, we still need to read a number. That second number we read could be positive or negative. Second number's also negative. Let's take this the other way. If we've got, negative followed by positive, we copy a 5 and print. Hang on. I'm gonna jump way up here. Else, we're gonna take a 0 because they're both negative and print that out. So this accounts for every possibility. Negative, negative, print a 0. Negative, positive, print a 1. Positive, negative. Ooh, I just chucked. That's not right. Yeah, no, that's completely not right. Negative, positive. How did that fail? So if you're negative, we jump down here. Next number, if it's negative. How is it that I just chucked a number? Let's try this again. Positive, negative, we chuck them. So I'm sorry, it's positive, then negative. So positive, negative. For negative there, we jump here. Yeah, that's not where we're intending to jump. Positive, negative, go there. Okay, let's try this. Negative, positive, we print a 1. Positive, negative, we print a 1. Negative, negative, print a 0. Positive, positive, we print a 0. Now, could this be optimized? Well, certainly. Okay, yeah, so my ideal solution I ended up with yesterday did meet both of these criteria. I spent a little time trying to optimize this and figure out what could I do better. I came up with something really clever yesterday. I don't recall what it was. How did I do it? Oh, right. So, two of these are, we're going to take a number. Yeah, I get it. So, let's just arbitrarily say that, what's the first of these? First of these, we're going to take this copy from 4 and put it up there. And that way our other copy from 4 just go like so, we don't need this instruction. So that takes us down to 15 instructions. Just run our way through that. It's marginally more optimal, but there's still more optimization to be done. Yeah, we still have 3 instructions over where we need to be. Still 1 extra step over where we need to be, so there's still room for improvement. Maybe I need to switch the 4 and the 5. Yeah, let's do that. So we're gonna say this is gonna be copy from 5, this is copy from 4, this is copy from 4. And I need to invert all of my logic. Let's take copy from 5, put that down to, put this down here, this down here. I'm making a royal mess of this, am I not? Okay, so let's take our simplest case. We get a positive number, and then a negative number. Positive and negative is just going to jump us straight up here. Otherwise, we're going to take that, and that's right. This becomes an extra jump that we don't need. Else, if we start with a negative, and then we get a negative to follow, that's a little bit ugly. Okay, so we've got a negative after a positive. We're going to take a 4, just print it. Now, this is still 2 more instructions than what we need. How am I doing stepwise? Oh, 27. Not bad. So in some sense, this can be considered ideal. But there's still room for improvement. And so I search. Onward I search. Oh, hang on. We've got a copy from 4 there, and we've got a copy from 4 here. Is there some way I can make this work? Let's just say... There we go. Gets rid of an extra step there, or extra instruction. Takes us down to 13 instructions. Okay, and this is room for a final improvement somewhere. We're making progress. We're still 1 instruction longer than necessary. And we're still completing within 28 steps, which is good. So how do I improve further upon this? Okay, if we get a positive, and if we get a negative, we're gonna print a 1. Let's see, do I need this jump? Yeah, I do. I certainly do. So we start with a negative number, and we take our next number, and if it's negative... Yeah, it's curious. It's curious for sure. What if I try moving this copy from four instructions? So, you see how we got this jump here? What if I could take that jump and make it point to the same place this other jump points to? Namely, just print out the value. Make this jump point to that. And, okay, I think then if I move this, we have a positive and a negative. Yeah, I've got three jump commands at the end here, which is a bit redundant, is it not? If we have two negative numbers, just jump there directly. Otherwise, go up to the top. I think there's how you get 12 instructions. So, a little bit of deviousness. Understanding assembly code takes a bit of a warped mind. And look at that. I beat the required score of 28. So, this completes in 27 steps. And with 12 instructions, so, alright, absolute positive. I'm sure this means something. Haha! I have a feeling something, productive something. So, if the number's negative, if I remember right, this is saying if the number is negative, negate it before printing it. And they just want everything to be positive. Okay, so. Alright. Yeah, let's keep all the fanciness out of this for a second. Take a number. If it's negative. Gonna do some deviousness. Else we're just going to jump back and print it out. But if we have a negative number, then we need to copy it and subtract it from what we have in memory, and then print out that result. Is there a better way to do this? I do wonder. You would think so, right? Okay, so 9 and 37. There's definitely a more efficient way to go about this. Perhaps if I could get rid of this jump somehow, that'd be cool. I don't know. What could I do? So there's got to be some way to improve this program. I'm thinking something about this. Oh, here we are. So the fact that I've got to jump, then execute some steps, and then do another jump, that leaves room for optimization. So I could take these steps and just put them right there instead. And by the way, this is the sort of thing compilers do all the time. So that's kind of why I'm having such ease with doing this, is that I've studied compilers. I know, like, how they tend to reorganize code, at least to some extent, to come up with a minimal, compact form that does just what you need it to do. So if we're negative, we need to do the absolute value. Otherwise, we just print out the value. Now, is this jump special? I mean, do I need to be so fancy? I don't know. It works, though. But yeah, you'll note that Windows executables, or at least MS-DOS ones, at the start of the program will tend to have a jump instruction telling you where... Oh yeah, I guess that's an MS-DOS thing. It'll have a jump instruction telling you where to start the program. Because sometimes it's more efficient to leave some instructions at the beginning of the program that occasionally need to be executed. So those can be executed, and then unconditionally what follows executes just by virtue of the fact that the program counter keeps iterating. Alright. Oh, there's a person there. Is that me? That might be me. Did not notice that yesterday. Countdown. This was a fun one. Alright, so, yeah. Build a countdown program. So let's start with the basics again. So I'm going to start my program with a jump to the outbox, or past the outbox instruction. We have a zero value, we're just going to print that. We have a negative value. You know, if I remember right, yesterday I eventually figured out that I didn't need the zero thing at all. If we're negative, we're going to execute a routine that says print out the number, and while we're negative, just keep looping. And when we're not negative anymore, we just print. That doesn't look right. Okay, let's try it this way. So if we're negative, go up there, print it out. How did this work again last time? I don't remember. We're gonna do this by trial and error. Shame on me, but oh well. Print the number, add one. If we're negative, keep jumping and printing until we finally hit zero, and then, okay. So that'll work for negative numbers. Else! We'll take our number, print it out. Subtract one. And if we're zero, go back up here, where we print out the zero and go back. Else, we're just gonna jump here, I guess. Now, this does not handle the zero case, which is really a bummer. Alright, we'll add a special case for the zero. Just print it out. So we got a 12-step program. Ooh, I cannot bump. Right, I cannot bump unless I've actually read the number into memory. So we're going to read the number into memory, and that'll enable us to bump it. So there's 5, 4, and so forth. 3, 2, 1, 0, negative 2, 1, 0, 0, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. But that's not the solution I finished with yesterday. There's a better way to do this. There's a much better way to do this. Although, what I wrote did only require 73 steps to execute. But, yeah, in terms of instructions, I remember I was able to do much better. Okay, so for negative... how did I do this last time? I think I was able to do without this if zero instruction. Though I don't remember how. Let's get rid of it and just deal with it on faith. So we're negative, execute the thing up here, else print out, and yeah, there we go. Okay, let's try that. So I think that's successful as well, but that's not optimal. That did save an entire instruction, but I want to save two more. How do I cut out some more instructions? In particular, I think yesterday I was able to cut out one of the outbox instructions as just being redundant. But which one? And how? Oh, wait. Am I able to take this routine and just move it? So, I might be able to. So, copy to zero. If you've got a negative number, print it out and increment. And while we're negative, we keep printing and incrementing. There was a much better way to do this yesterday. I'm not remembering it. How do you do a countdown timer? Jump if negative, go way up here. That executes the negative routine. You've got a zero. I mean, this should... there should be a way to collapse some of that. I think what was burning me yesterday is that the bump instruction... oh, that's right. In order to bump, there has to be something in the register. And the bump also loads the value out of the register and puts it into your... oh, I'm sorry, loads it out of the cache and puts it into your hand, into your register. So, yeah, the ideal time to print out is after we've done a bump. Not before it. So, drawing a blank here. Such a blank. I mean, this works. I'm just wanting to do something better. Well, I appear to be stumped. That's something else. It's definitely something else. Wait, yesterday did I find a way to, like, combine the bumps? That would be messy, but... potentially then I'd have only one Lupin variant. I don't like all this jumping I'm doing down here. I get this. This makes sense to me. Could move these routines about or around and see if I come up with something better. Yeah. If zero outbox. I move this. Put that there. Put that there. I mean, that shouldn't impact anything. Just for clarity's sake, yeah, for zero, we're done. So if we got a positive number, print it out. Negate. And if we got a negative number, then we're done. Else repeat the loop. I mean, this is still the 12 instructions, right? I didn't manage to get rid of any of these outbox steps. This keeps looping while negative. There's gotta be a better way. First of all, is this correct? Did I break the program? I think this is still fine. I think I didn't break anything. Yeah, so this is a solution. Less optimal than what we had yesterday. There's still ways to do better. Maybe I do this. No. I want to do the inbox and copy to zero. As the start of what I do. That's fine. So this is where our program begins. This inbox, copy. For negative, go up there. And do our negative loop. Let me just start over. I'm getting pretty stale on the ideas here. Read the number. Copy it to the one next to the conveyor belt, because why not? We're zero, we're gonna go up there and print out our zero. Meaning that when we start the program, you're gonna first read from the inbox. So, what do I wanna do? I was thinking put the if zero first and then do an if negative. Not sure where all that would go. Yeah, I'm not sure where any of this is going, but seeing putting the if zero first seems pretty flimsy. But let's try it out. Give it a chance. So for not negative, we're going to print out the number. Subtract 1. And then jump back to see, are we 0? Else, if we are already negative, that's where we can put our extra routine up here in this space. Well, it doesn't... I don't know if it matters. We'll see. Yeah, if we're negative, we're going to print out the negative number, add 1, and jump back here. Check, are we still negative? Or check, are we 0? That's so inefficient, and I'm bumping the value in the wrong register. Yeah, this is hugely inefficient, but it's a different way to solve the problem, or to achieve the desired end. Yeah, that was very inefficient, because we're checking this if zero every time. So if we're negative, go down this way. Let's move like that. Negative, do this routine, jump. Whatever. This is still 12 instructions, and it's the wrong input. Alright. Alright, so that didn't work at all. Let's try again. Take a number. It's negative. We're going to go up to the top. Hang on. Take a number. Put it in a memory location. I don't know. I like this memory location 4. It's negative. Go up to the top. Our top routine is going to be print out the number, increment, and if we're still negative, keep repeating. There we go. Start of the program is going to be read the number. Okay, and if we've got a positive value, we're just going to print it out. And then I'm bumping the value in the wrong register again. So bump register 4, or cache location 4. For 0, we're done printing things and we're going to get the next number. Else, we're just going to keep this positive loop going. This is another... Well, I was going to say it was a valid solution. That's not valid at all. Okay, where did this mess up? Oh, I forgot at the end of this positive sequence to print the 0. Okay. I think that should be fine. 4, 2, 1. Yeah. So that prints the 0 after all the positive numbers. That's more efficient step count wise. However, this is still not the ideal solution. Alright, so for negative, I'm not sure what to do. There's some solution that involves 10 instructions instead of 12. So there's... it's gonna involve fewer jumps than what we have. Or maybe fewer outbox commands. Let me try something a bit crazy. Again, I apologize for resetting this so often, but... I'm going to start by printing the number, and then read the value out. For negative, I'm going to go back to the beginning. Seems highly inefficient and are wrong already. Okay, so routine for negative numbers is we increment and then print, and then while or negative, just keep doing that. You know, let me try this a different way, where we read the number, copy it into the register, and then if we're negative, don't jump back to the top, jump below. Right, now we're holding on to the number still in our hand. We do need to print it, and if it's a 0, then we're done and we go back here. Otherwise, decrement the value in the cache. And jump and print that out. Okay, but if we started with a negative number, then we need to print it out still. And increment it. For a 0, we're done. Else, we need to go back into our loop again. I think this works. So this takes our 4. It's at 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. That's not right. Oh, right. So this is saying, yeah, you can't just print out the number unless you're going to load it. Fine. So we load the number. And that's ugly. 4, 3. Oh, I get it. Instead of this copy from, let's see, there's our jump if 0. We're going to say jump if negative after doing that. There we go. So we can read and jump at this. You'll see. So 5, and then we print out our 4. And what's going to get be interesting is when we get the 0, that this is going to load and decrement and get to negative 1 and just say, oh, we're done. So I cut out an instruction. It does require an additional step per iteration, I guess, but it saves an instruction. Ooh, that's not good. That aborted early. Yeah, if we're negative, we need to do this routine down here. We print out the number, increment, and if we're 0, we need to just print out the number and end up where we ended up, else keep going in our negative loop. Alright, so this should work. So, this does the solution with 11 instructions, but it's possible to do in 10. And yeah, that exceeded the requirement of 82. But yeah, I think this jump is correct. Not sure what else could be stripped out at this point. Without, like, ruining the program. I do like having this little loop down there just for negative numbers, but there's probably a better way to do this. Where does this take us? Yeah, there's got to be some better way to structure this. I did minimize the number of outbox commands. That was a good thing. But can I take either of these routines and stick it at the top and still expect to get a good result? I assume the latter of these could be put at the top. Does this work? I definitely like this set, where we take the number, put it in memory. If what we're holding is negative, skip down there. We're gonna print it out. And if we load and subtract and end up with something negative, we just say we're done. Definitely like that. Let's see. How did I do this yesterday? I know I got this, and without too much difficulty. I'm just not as flexible of mind today, it appears. For 0, we print out the number. Hoi vey. Can I somehow take these two outbox instructions and merge them into one? Let's try that. I'm not too confident about this. Take the number outbox. Yeah, and then copy from 4. And if we're 0, but go back up, you know, let me just trash all this and try writing it procedurally. If we're 0, we need to go back up to the top. This is hideous. I don't like it already. Yeah, I definitely don't like to use this copy from instruction. That inspires no confidence in me. Take the value, say for negative, go up to the top, or the bottom, or something. Okay, so for positive, we're going to... let me give this a try. This wastes an instruction. I'm really not too pleased with that. There's gotta be some... Because now I've only got 4 instructions left. And 2 of them are gonna need to be bumps. One of them's... The other 2 are gonna need to be outboxes, and the other 2 are gonna need to be jumps. So that's not gonna work. I can't start this program with a jump instruction and expect to have enough instructions left to execute the rest of this. Copy to 4 needs to be one of these instructions. I can't do without copying the input number somewhere into memory. I'll try it this way. I keep hesitating on this one. I don't like it, but... So... Let's put this down here. We can always reorder it later if we need to. Print out the number. Increment the number. Jump back here. This is what I was kind of aiming for. I'll print out the number and decrement it. And if we're negative, go back to the start. So I think this is 9 instructions. I think this actually is a valid solution. It's just inefficient as heck. 6, and then the 5. 4. Oh. Wait, how did I mess that up? Nine. So we're negative, we're going to go down here. How did I mess that up? So normally, well, let's just step 1 step at a time. Take that, decrement it. For negative, I'm missing a jump command. That's where my jump command's missing. There we go. 8765-43210, I hope. Okay, so this is 10 instructions. It's a valid solution. And how many steps? Oh, yeah. I was pretty sure this is going to exceed the desired step count. So, question is, how do you optimize this further? This is, like, the least efficient program I can come up with that satisfies the requirement. Again, for those just arriving, requirement is to take the number from the input queue and then count down or count up to zero and just print it out one step at a time. I'm just trying to see, is there a more efficient way I can do this? There's a lot of jumping going on in this program. But yeah, there's definitely a more efficient way to solve this. Isn't too terrible, but this could be made considerably better. I came up with a longer program that was just 73 steps. I think it was like 14 instructions. I think I can do better than this. I'm just not so clear on how. Yeah, it's basically asking me to save one step per loop. Gotta work on our calculus functions. That sounds, yeah, it's tricky stuff. Wait, I've got if jump if negative up here, then I've got a jump, and then this next thing I do is check jump if negative. Just reorder these two, because this jump if negative, if we got a negative number we're holding in our hand, we'll just go to the start of the program. Otherwise, if we don't have a negative number, then this extra comparison's not necessary. So I can reorder the steps a little bit. I don't need to do that jump if negative check twice. That might be the optimization it's looking for. Let's see how we did. 10's good. 87. We're almost there. So, possibly some other reordering of instructions might improve this. We're definitely getting into the weeds here. Man, I solved this yesterday, so I'm. I just wish I had it here. We're getting really close, though. I'm just really tempted to, like, move these last few instructions up to the top somehow. There's got to be some way to... Like, here we've got a routine that just for negative numbers... Okay, well... In fact, we have an unconditional jump here, right? So... Oh, but I can't move these things up to the top unless I'm going to add a jump instruction at the very beginning saying start here. I'm confusing myself pretty badly. This is not a bad solution. I just wish I could do a little bit better. I don't want to give up on this. Is there a way I can do this with 9 instructions? Copy to 4. Print it out. Decrement. If we're negative, go up to the top and increment. Yeah. The minute I start putting anything interesting at the top, I need to put an extra jump there. There's gotta be some really fun way I can order all these jump instructions. How many jumps do I have in total? I've got 2 unconditional jumps, 2 conditional jumps. Wait. Yeah, I can't say jump if 0 there because. I'm not holding anything in memory. The bump command takes the value out of the cache and puts it in my hand. So I need to do this bump before I do the comparison. Print out the number, increment, and then jump to here. Oh, hang on. So if we just added 1 and we jump, we're not going to get a negative number. So that should make our... should speed up our looping a little bit. So, remember that check I moved around? It turns out we actually do need this comparison. Well, I'm not sure why. First of all, does this solve it? Or did I fail to restore my solution properly? No, that's a valid solution. It's just not ideal. My unconditional jump has to go up here. But I wonder why. It doesn't seem to make much sense. Is there some way I could put the one bump before the other bump and do some fun stuff? Maybe. I wonder what the ideal solution to this is. There's really only so many programs you can generate using this set of instructions. So the reason for that so that when we get negative 1, we end up going down here and adding 1, and then printing out the 0. Just feels like I'm doing something fundamentally wrong here. So often it's just easier to just throw out the whole program and start over. You get a lot more variety and diversity that way, because a person's mind wanders. Let me just chuck this program altogether. Take the value, I'm gonna copy it into memory. Increment it. And if we're negative, do some stuff. Else, decrement it. And print out the value. Not sure how this is going to work. I've only got 4 instructions left. At least one of them is going to have to be an unconditional jump back up to the start. Negative. Okay, so I'm sorry. We added 1, we subtracted 1, printed out our positive value. That's ugly. That is very ugly. Dare I try this the other way? So, bump 4, bump address 4. I do find it funny, they give you all these registers to play with, and really to use all of them, you'd have to write a really sophisticated program that would just be extremely confusing. So that's a huge misleading something or other. Let me try this how I was initially trying to do it. So, instruction 1 is going to be jump to where inbox command is. Outbox. Hang on, we need to copy this into memory. And if the value is negative, then we're going to go up here and go through a loop. So I've already exhausted 5 instructions. Add 1 to the value in memory. While we're negative, just keep doing that. I've used up so many instructions here, it's truly a mess. Otherwise, if we're positive, we need to decrement the value. Oh, let me take this and move it down there. or negative, go up here, add one. That's not right either. This is what I was trying to do earlier. So there, I've used up all my instructions. And I'm no closer to the solution. So, yeah, no. Instruction 1's gonna have to be read the number. Instruction 2 is going to be we have to cache that away for later use. Assume 3 is going to be if 0, go back to the start. 4 is probably going to be if we're negative, go down there. Well, I just defied myself, but whatever. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Sorry, I'm going through a lot of possibilities in my mind. I'll have to come back to this problem, unfortunately. So I'm flustered that I did not get the best solution. Alright. Something about adding numbers. Something. Okay. For each 2 numbers in the inbox, multiply. And print. I guess the product in the output box. Wait, what's going on here? How come I got special things? For each 2 numbers in the inbox, multiply them and print out their product in the outbox. I'm guessing that's what it says. Make each something, something, something. I'm not sure. Also, this seems extremely goofy here. That there's a register by the name of Hello, and a register by the name of Null. So I guess it's just telling me I have to keep these instructions. No, I don't. Wait. I don't understand why I would even want to use those. That seems hilarious and stupid. You have new instructions. Curious what this is for. I really don't see a use for any of that. Let's execute this program. Hello. Hello. It's the unhalting program. Just for your own amusement. But yeah, he's gonna enjoy doing that all day. You have Zetel Erhalten. I have to admit, it just seems silly. Why would you use any of that? Poor guy just keeps multiplying numbers. Okay, we're gonna read a number. We're gonna copy it into here. I'm gonna read another number. Copy it into the other register. And how do I do their product? That's a good question. Oh, I get it. This is the point of that zero. This is a hint telling you you're going to want to load a zero into there before you start doing anything. Very clever. So, yeah, take a number, copy it into, say, here, take another number, copy it into there. And the latter of those two numbers, once that hits zero, I'm going to skip to the end of this routine, which is going to say just copy from the hello register and print it out. Otherwise, if we're not zero, then take the number out of register zero and copy it into hello, or add it to hello. Copy from zero. Add hello. No. We're gonna copy from hello. We're gonna add the value in register zero. And copy that back to hello. And then decrement the value that's the multiplicand, I think. So yeah, load up a zero, take the one, take your two, add your one, keep that away, subtract the one, and then do that again, subtract, and print out the number. And then, yeah, you need to do this kind of multiplication stuff. And I guess you can safely assume that both numbers are positive. Now, there's a 15-step program that does multiplication. Oh, 15 was what I expected. Greatly exceeded the instruction count, however. That doesn't surprise me that it did poorly there. But yeah, that makes sense. You'd want to load up a zero, and then do all your math. And if if you have a value of 0, end your routine and such, and just print out, and go back to the beginning. Is there a better way to do multiplication? I mean, goodness, there must be. There must be a better way to multiply. Not seeing it though. Considering all these kinds of possibilities, and yet none of them really stand out. So maybe I want to say. This is confusing. I think I'm surprised that 15 is the correct number of instructions. That just seems spectacular to me that there isn't a program with 14 instructions that achieves the same end. All kinds of off-by-one shortcuts that could be attempted here. I'm just not sure where to even start. But I'm so far from the goal. If you remember, and I could run this again, I exceeded the expected instruction count by about 50%. So there's a lot of room for improvement. There's definitely room for improvement here. I'm just trying to find where would I start. I don't want to do something that's going to be, I don't know, hugely controversial or causing me to rewrite the entire program. There's also no divide instruction, so there's no bit shift, there's none of that. This is a really, really minimal instruction set. Zero, we're jumping to the end. So, I mean, this is the part that troubles me. Is there some way they can say, execute instructions and then, I guess undo them? I just want to make some of these loops tighter. But that doesn't seem practical. It's funny, we, on a different program, we managed to discover which of the numbers is greater. And based on which number is greater, we were able to do interesting things. Here, that would not be so bright. But yeah, you can take the greater number and use that as the one you're adding. You note that the sample data takes care to... at least I think it ensures that you get... I don't know. Does it say anything about the ordering of the numbers? And that which one is going to be greater? It does not. Huh. That's goofy. Okay, arguably I could take these instructions and put them first. So load our numbers, then start the multiplication. Copy the zero into the hello cell. And then this way we have the zero in our hand to begin with. We don't need to load the zero anymore. Oh, in fact, yeah, that's interesting. That copy to hello command seems a bit silly. I mean, what am I using that particular register for anyway? I guess I'm using it so that at the end I'll have something to load from. This is an unconditional jump back here. Oh, I forgot, this bump instruction will... Yeah, that's the problem. Take the second number, decrement it. If we end up with a negative value jump down instead of if we have a zero jumping. This is still 15 instructions. We might execute one loop quicker or something. It's functionally equivalent, so what's the point? There's no point to doing it that way. Well, let's try it that way anyhow. What's the worst that could happen? Okay, copy from hello. Add zero, copy to hello. Jump. This will produce a valid result, right? You got a 1 and a 2. And you decrement that. We add the 1. Decrement that again. Add the 1 and the 1. Stick that in hello. Decrement that. Load that in. Yeah, so that produces the right number. Reordered the instructions a little bit, but didn't really make any things any faster. Maybe even made it a touch slower, I'm not sure. Again, I've managed to do this with just 15 instructions. Yeah, I think my previous attempt was 164. I managed to successfully increase the instruction count. That's no big deal. So how do I do? How do I do the do? In fact, if I go back here to the workshop, so it gives me the sample program to start with. Oh, this must be a way of caching programs, so you can try something and then go back. That's useful. All right. Load a number, copy it to somewhere, load another number, copy it to another space. If we're zero, then jump down there, saying copy from our product cell. Print the number. Else, we're going to... Well, I guess either way, we're going to copy from the product cell. Oh, then we can't jump. Huh. Yeah, there's no way to say jump based on a value that I don't have in memory. That's inconvenient. Here, we're going to copy from the product, add the value there, and then jump back up. This is not going to produce the right result, because it doesn't have the right number of instructions. Yeah, well, that's completely wrong. And exciting, but completely wrong. There we go. Let's try that. I think that was my original solution. which, again, was 15 instructions, however, was 164 steps, and there's a faster way to do it. I should observe in the sample data that the larger number tends to be the second one. But I can't afford to add another load instruction in here. That's funny. Man, there's so many ways you could change this program, but they all require additional instructions. It's so confusing. Try it the other way around. So that didn't actually make a huge difference. Infinite loop. Mission accomplished. Yeah. How did I even end up in that situation? That's pretty funny. All right, for this set of sample data, how well did I do? Still 164 steps. I mean, I don't know a more efficient way to do multiplication than this. Negative numbers to do dark magic. Deepest, darkest of magics could be done with negative numbers here. Is there any value to doing it with negative numbers other than just because we can? I don't know. It might be. Yeah, see here where we say jump if zero? So here we could say just add from hello, right? Because we're going to only end up down there if we have zero, right? Similarly, I could change this to say subtract from address 0 and subtract from hello. And that would be equally valid. It's silly, but it's valid. Just to prove my point. Just do everything with subtraction. Negative 14, negative 21, and, I mean, yeah, you can get the same result this way. It looks ridiculous, and I'm pretty sure there's no point to it, but it's doable. But yeah, there must be a better way. Like this program where it says copy from 0. And then, I mean, this is silly, because there are other ways to do multiplication that don't involve starting with a zero, and involve some arithmetic to end up with zero. But this is a foolproof way to do it. Well, I appear to be stuck at the moment, so I'm going to go back to the puzzle list. And do some more side questing. Fibonacci Boisher. Okay. So it's going to ask you, what's the 10th number of the Fibonacci sequence? What's the 21st number of the Fibonacci sequence? And so forth. That seems like a bit of a challenge, actually. Or is this asking for print out the first 10 numbers? Well, let's do the dumb thing. And by dumb, I mean fun. Take the first number, print it out. Oh, that's incorrect. Yeah, so this wants the first X numbers of the Fibonacci sequence. Well, there we have a zero, right? Copy from there. Copy to here, and I'm going to bump this. Oh, I get it. This is actually going to be, this is going to be fun. So we're going to take the number from here. Copy it to somewhere. And then say, for negative, jump to the beginning. Just going to print out the number. Okay, so our initialization routine is going to be copy the zero, dump it over here, and increment it. Fibonacci sequence with this kind of stuff is actually really messy. Oh, hang on. Let me first focus on what does it take to initialize this. Right? So our initialization is going to be copy from there. Paste it over here. As well as pasting it over here. Does that even work? Okay, so yeah, copy to just takes the item in hand. Which could be a zero for all we care, and prints it. So we've got a zero and a zero. Actually, this is going to tear my mind apart. I'm going to come back to this one later. I need food. I really do. The inbox is null terminated. What is it? Something, probably heck if I know, I don't know. Print the sum in the outbox as soon as we have a zero. Alright. Take a number from the inbox. We need to copy from copy the file. Oh, wait. No, take the inbox number, copy it to something. In fact, let's copy it to the closest register here. Oh, but a zero itself could terminate the sequence. My bad. Take the number. Okay, so we need to copy from the zero. Put it somewhere. And when we're done, we're going to need to load that value and print it. In the interim, we read a number. If it's zero, yeah, then we go up to that printing routine here. However, the start of our program is going to skip those two steps, as we don't want to immediately print a number. So there's our initialization. There's reading a number from the inbox. If it's zero, we take a number there and print it. Else, well, eventually we're going to end up at our end of our routine, which is just going to take the next number out of the inbox. But else, we're going to add the number there and store it there. Right? Let's take a zero, initialize that, take our two, add it to the zero, cache it away. Take our 8, put the sum there, and when we have a 0, just say take the number and print it out. And reinitialize, add a 7, add a negative 7. Add a 5. And then print out the result of the sequence, which is just a 5. Next, initialize. Oh, we have a null terminated sequence. Print out the sum. Okay. And initialize again. Print out sum, which is another 0. And you get the picture. So then add the rest of these numbers together. Observe that their sum does get printed out. Oh, I could do better. Alright, how shall I do better? I don't know, I thought I did pretty well here. So take the input number. If it's a zero, then we need to print out our values and return. How do you improve upon this? How do you do that? Do I need this initialization stuff? I think I do. Yeah, if we have a sequence that's just a zero, we just print out a zero. That's not going to happen often. I'm confused. How can I do better? Doing better is going to require some reordering of these instructions, but I'm not sure exactly what. It just blows my mind that a 10 instruction program could be optimized. Fun little animation, too. It's as if I could just keep adding numbers from the input to what I'm holding on to. Maybe that's the more efficient way. That work? Yeah, no. Immediately after I read, I have to check, is this a zero? There's no other way. If it is a zero, take the sum and print it. A number here, and the most efficient way to check if it's zero or non-zero is the if zero command. Yeah, and I am very confused. How do you improve upon this? Without cheating.
I able to just load out of that cache 5? I'm just confused. I mean, unless I can do away with that initialization step, how can I improve upon this? In order to read a number, I need to discard the number in my hand. That seems like a really limiting, thing. It's not like I can just build up a stack of numbers in my hand and then choose what to do with them. Have a zero, I mean, I could either do a copy from or an add, it doesn't matter. I could just as easily say add from register 2, and that would work just fine. But there's no point. I mean, yeah, see, I've got an add 2 here, and I've got an add 2 there. But I have to check the value 0 before I invoke the add 2 instruction. I don't have the luxury of being able to do the addition and then check, was my value 0? There's no swap instruction either, and sure as heck is not going to be one of these bump instructions. That would be special, but that's not it. I'm just really confused. Well, I solved it, but not ideally. Let's take a look at this one. For the null term, for the null terminated, I guess, sequence in the inbox. I guess it's saying, I'm not sure what this is asking. Is this asking for putting the smallest number in a null terminated sequence into the outbox? Kleine? I think kleine means little. So, Kleinst might just be saying, give us the smallest number, or the minimum of these, and put that into the outbox. There'll always be a number, I guess. So this is actually a little tricky. Take the number, just copy it there, Take another number. Subtract the value. Oh. Hang on. Card number is 0. Then copy from 0 and print out the number. Start at the beginning here. And if our number is not 0, then we'll subtract the value that's in 0. If we have a negative number, then it means we subtracted something greater than ourselves. In which case, we will re-add the 0. And copy our little number into 0. And keep repeating this routine down here. I think that should be okay. So we get a 7 and a 15. We subtract 2 minus 7. So we want the 2. And then we take our 2, stick it over here. Yeah, so this is a valid solution. 5 is the smaller of 5 and 11. 2 is the smaller of 5 and 2. And then we want to print out our 2. So this is how you find the minimum of a sequence. Is there a more efficient way? Unquestionably, there must be. Ooh, did I mess that up? Or maybe that didn't say 11. Oh, 13 instructions. 73 steps. Excellent. That was an ideal solution. At least it was an adequate solution. For each number of the inbox, take the sum of the number plus null in the outbox. Oh, take the sum of the number going down to 0 and output it. This is not in English because programming games would be too easy if I were to do them in English. So I am seeking to do something a little different today. But yeah, when it puts the problem statement like this, that actually kind of takes some of the challenge out of discovering what it wants. Yeah, we're gonna take a number in the inbox. Wait. Okay, so our initialization step is going to be copy from 0, copy the 0 into here, read a number from the inbox. If it's 0, then we're going to print out the number that's currently residing in cache location 0. Otherwise, we're going to copy our number to address 3. Add the value that's in 0. Copy that into address 0. Decrement the value that we put into address 3. And that also loads it into memory. And then jump back up here. So if I got... Wait. Oopsie-daisy, I forgot to say that step one is going to be jump to the initialization routine. So take our 0, that's our sum. Take our 4, put it here, add the 4,
stash it away, take a 3, add that, put that in our sum, stash it away. And this is how you just get a sum of numbers. So sum of 1, 2, 3, and 4 goes there. Here's our initialization again. Not a big deal. The reason we have to initialize it, because what if we get a 0 in the input? We just need to take the 0 and print it out. Now there might be a more efficient way to do that. Yeah, let me skip through the rest of these steps. You can see them add numbers together. And it's an adequate solution. Oh, 12 instructions is what they were looking for. 106 steps is definitely not what they were looking for. So there's got to be some tighter way to execute this. Yeah. This is a fun game. I like the way it's animated. And I was initially saying that I wish this were more challenging or had some kind of expert mode. But some of these puzzles, at least optimizing them, is a bit of a challenge, so turns out that doing this in German might have been more than necessary to obtain a challenge out of it. So we take a number from the inbox. Copy it to 3. There must be some more efficient way to organize all this. I'm not seeing it. But I did get a valid solution. Let's just take a look at the next puzzle. We did take a look at the Fibonacci sequence, and I chickened out. I actually want to take a look at this. Just see how the story develops. And might actually wrap things up here. If I could, I would. But I can't, so I shan't. Pretty cool. And ominous. I mean, yeah, what better way to transition? So, with that, I think I'll take a break. And sorry, I know you just arrived, but I've been doing this a while, and I need to have food, else I'm not going to focus very well. So, thanks for stopping by, and I hope to see you around next time. Have a good one.